Hi folks, hope you're okay today. Good to be with you. It says in the Bible, give us commendation to them which is in Christ Jesus. We walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the Lord, the Spirit of life, is Christ Jesus that made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do is that it was weak through the flesh. God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. They that are of the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is at enmity against God, and is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can it be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. You are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. If so, be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin. The Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by the Spirit that is in you. Saying here, when Christ died and rose again, but when Christ died and rose again, the Spirit of God was given to the church. The Spirit of God was given to those who believe in him. But the Holy Spirit is the promise and the victory of the resurrected Christ. That when Christ rose again, the Father was well pleased and gave the Holy Spirit to the church. Jesus said, I send you a counselor. I send you the comforter. He will not speak of himself, but he will speak of me. And the Holy Spirit is the one that quickens us and helps us to understand what the Bible is all about. We cannot understand the Bible. We cannot read the Bible and understand it unless we allow the Holy Spirit to teach us. I can give you arguments all day long. I can give you loads of arguments to show you that the Bible is the Word of God. But if you desire not to believe, there's nothing I can do to convince you. But there is one who is able to convince you. And he is the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit bears witness to the truth. The Holy Spirit bears witness to Jesus. The Holy Spirit opens our eyes to the truth. And if you want to know the truth, the Spirit of God will set you free. The Spirit of God will open your eyes. The Spirit of God will show you what the Bible means. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to the Spirit. And we need to be spiritual men and women. And the way to be a spiritual man and woman is to allow the Holy Spirit to open our eyes. Allow the Holy Spirit to come into our lives. Jesus says, you must be born again. Which means born by the Holy Ghost. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh to live after the flesh. For if we live after the flesh, you shall die. But if you live through the Spirit, do mortify the deeds of the body, you shall live. If you mortify the deeds of the body, if you put to death that which is wrong in your life, and allow the Holy Spirit to work in your life, and allow the Holy Spirit to change you, allow the Holy Spirit to fill you, allow the Holy Spirit to make you anew, put to death that which is wrong in your life, and allow God to change you, and allow God to work in your life by the Spirit of God. For if you live after the flesh, you shall die. If you live after yourself, If you live independent of God, it says you shall die. But not only die in this world, but die in eternity, in hell. So mortify the deeds of the body, you shall live. In other words, anything in your life that is wrong, anything in your life that is pulling you down, turn away from it. Anything that's bringing in sin, or what is bringing in ungodliness, turn away from it. Turn away from anything that is poisoning your mind and blinding your mind and hurting your family and hurting you spiritually. You need to get away from it. Gambling isn't good. It's not going to help you or your family. You know, whatever is pulling your family down and you down, mortify the deeds of the body, put to death that which is wrong in your life, turn away from it. And turn and walk in the Holy Spirit and allow the Holy Spirit to have control of your life. Allow the Holy Spirit to have control of your marriage, control of your sex life. Allow the Holy Spirit to have control of your money, control of your anger. If you're getting angry, you need to stop getting angry and allow the Holy Spirit to fill you so you're not getting angry anymore. Let the Holy Spirit change you and let the Holy Spirit make you anew. If you're feeling depressed, thank you, sir. Thanks for your love, bro. I love that. Thank you. Allow the Holy Spirit to work in your life. Allow it to change you and to fill you and make you anew. We have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption where we cry, Abba Father. He says, we have received the spirit of adoption. When you become born again, you become adopted in the family of God. When you come to know Jesus, you become adopted in the family of God. And that means you don't have to fear. Are you living in fear today? Are you fearing bombs going off in Korea? Are you fearing nuclear bombs in North Korea? Are you fearing you can't pay your bills? Are you fearing that you might get cancer? What are you fearing today? What is the fear in your life? You don't have to have fear today. You don't have to have fear. The moment you believe in Jesus Christ, you have become adopted in the family of God. And if you become adopted in the family of God, you have the love of God on your side. You have the love of God with you. You have the love of God giving you strength. You have the love of God helping you, because you become adopted in the family of God by believing in Jesus. So don't walk around with fear. If you have fear today, whatever you fear, don't fear. Don't fear. Remember, the moment you believe in Jesus Christ, you have become adopted in the family of God. And all the privileges of a child of God are with you. All the glory of God, all the blessings of God, all the love of God goes with you, my friend. All God is with you if you trust in Him. You become adopted in the family of God. You become a child of God. And God works with you. God is with you. So don't walk in fear today. If you're walking in fear, remember that if you trust in Jesus, you don't have to fear anything. A nuclear bomb could go off in North Korea. A nuclear bomb could go off in America. ISIS could drop a bomb in Chester. But you don't have to fear a thing, because if you believe in Jesus Christ, you are adopted in the family of God. And God is with you. And God will keep you, my friend. God bless you.
Okay.